iOS 17.2 came with some big features, so in this video I'm going to give you my top 10. Not only the new Journal app capturing spatial video on iPhone 15 Pro, you can actually use NameDrop to share movie tickets or boarding passes, the Weather app got some big updates and some new widgets, and a new live translation option with the action button is one of the coolest animations in iOS so far. First up is the live translation with the action button. If I hold the action button down, it will translate live whatever I'm saying into another language. Not only that, but it will speak it out loud in the other language. Can you tell me where the nearest restaurant is?
¿Puedes decirme dónde está el restaurante más cercano?
Pretty cool animation, right? And if it detects another language, it will translate it back to English automatically. ¿Si puedes entender qué está hablando?
If you can understand what he's talking about.
My Spanish may be a little rusty, but it did translate it back into English. To choose what language it's going to translate to, go to the Translate app and then just choose which language you would like down here. For instance, if I go to French, now I can ask it, where is the nearest restaurant?
Où est le restaurant le plus proche?
Pretty cool. Number two, the new Journal app on iOS 17.2 is a big deal. I actually did an entire video dedicated just to the Journal app. I'll link it above and in the video description. While it's still missing some features, especially if you're a longtime journaler and you use Day One app, I think it's a great start for someone just trying to get into journaling. And I love that it brings in your podcast, music, photos, locations, and even contacts that you've had conversations with. Number three, if you have an iPhone 15 Pro or Pro Max, you can actually start shooting spatial video right now to view on Apple Vision Pro. Go to Settings, Camera, and then Formats, scroll down, and then you'll see the option for Spatial Video for Apple Vision Pro. Toggle this on, then whenever you're in the camera app ready to capture video, you'll see this Apple Vision Pro icon in the bottom right corner. Toggle that on, and now you're recording 1080p spatial video that you'll be able to experience on the Apple Vision Pro. Keep in mind, spatial video is 1080p, there's no 4K option. So if you want the highest quality video, I would not do spatial video, just keep it to 4K. But if you plan on getting an Apple Vision Pro, you can start capturing memories now to experience in spatial video. All right, number four is actually an update that came with watchOS 10.2. I used to love swiping back and forth between my watch faces right here on the main screen. They actually removed that feature in watchOS 10, but they brought it back. If you go to Settings on your Apple Watch, then scroll down to Clock, you'll now have the toggle where you can swipe between your Apple Watch faces right from the main screen. Number five, there are new features a part of NameDrop where you can actually share passes, whether it's a boarding pass for a flight, a loyalty pass, or even movie tickets or sporting events. For instance, here on my iPhone, I can go to a boarding pass. This was a former boarding pass, not something you can use right now. But if I wanted to share this with another iPhone, I can actually hold the iPhones head to head with the boarding pass on the top. And you'll see it'll now give me the option to share that boarding pass with the other iPhone. I can just hit share, and now it's in the wallet of the other iPhone. Number six, Siri can now access your health data and you can ask it for some of that information or log that information too. You can ask it things like, how many hours did I sleep last night? And it'll tell you how many hours. To enable Siri access to your health data, go to Settings, then go to Health, Data Access and Devices, and there you'll see Siri and you can enable it here. If you don't see Siri in that list, then just try to ask Siri for like how many hours you slept last night, and it'll give you a link to be able to enable that in Settings. Number seven, the Weather app got some big updates in iOS 17.2. Now when you look at the wind data, you actually get a wind map for your location, or you can scroll around and see the entire country, and it will show you that wind data on a really cool interactive map. And if you go to a specific day, you could see precipitation totals like down here, and you also get a little more moon phase information. Now you have the days separated here, and you can scroll back and forth and see the phases of the moon as you scroll. Weather also got some more widgets. You now have a smaller forecast widget you can add to the home screen, a weather details widget, and a sunrise sunset widget. There's also a new digital clocks widget which has the seconds going around the frame. All right, those new widgets were actually number eight. So number nine, there's actually better controls for iMessages in the cloud. Back to the Settings app, I can tap my name at the top, which accesses iCloud settings. Then I'll go to iCloud, show all, and now you'll see messages in iCloud. Tapping that, I can actually toggle it on or off for this device. It tells me the storage messages is taking up. I can choose how long to keep my messages. I'm a forever kind of guy. How many messages are currently in the cloud, and the last sync status. And one of the best features here is you can now manually sync now your iMessages on iPhone. Previously, you could only do this in the Messages app on the Mac, but now you can do it on iPhone and iPad. Makes it really nice where you can just manually force sync your messages in the cloud. And number 10, there's way better PDF autofill on iOS. If you have a PDF, let's say here in Notes, this is like a W9 form, you can actually zoom in, and when you tap a field like name, it'll actually give you the autofill options right here. Depending on the field, you'll get your personal information from the Contacts app, but this will make PDFs even easier to fill out on your iPhone, iPad, and these autofill features are on the Mac as well. Before we get to the 17.3 update, two other little bonus features and updates. If you go to your focus filters here in Settings, I'll go to my filming one, there's now an additional focus filter for music. So if you're going to be playing songs or tracks during a focus mode and you don't want those songs to update your listening history, you can toggle this off, and then you can be confident any music you play while in this focus mode won't affect your listening history, and maybe you'll actually get a usable Apple Music replay at the end of the year, unlike me. There's also a new tapback feature in Messages, so if I tap and hold on a message, I have all my tapback options here, like the like and heart, but I can also add a sticker right here. Maybe I'll choose this AI-generated version of myself, and I can add that sticker onto the message just by tapping and holding. Now, iOS 17.3 Beta 1 just launched as I was making this video, and there's an incredible new feature that is going to help the security of your iPhone. This is called Stolen Device Protection. The first time you update to 17.3, you're going to see the splash screen explaining that certain features will require Face ID or Touch ID to change. I'll put a link to this Mac Rumors article in the video description, but if you scroll down, you'll see all the things that will require Face ID or Touch ID in order to be changed. That includes using passwords or passkey saved in iCloud keychain, which is a big one, applying for a new Apple card, erasing all content and settings on the device, using your phone to set up a new device, payments in Safari, and so on. This is a huge deal. I actually did a video a little while ago about how to make the most secure passcode on your iPhone possible. I'll link that video up here and in the description. The reason being, if someone were to get your passcode and your physical iPhone, they could reset your Apple ID password and basically wreak havoc on your entire Apple ecosystem and your iCloud account. That includes your entire iCloud photo library, your saved passwords like for your bank account and iCloud keychain. And this feature is a big step in the right direction for Apple. This means that even if someone has your passcode and your physical iPhone, they would not be able to access your iCloud passwords or keychain without Face ID or Touch ID if you have that kind of device. Not only that, but there's also going to be a 1 hour security delay on changing some of the features on your iPhone, including changing your Apple ID password. If someone were to try to disable the device protection, there's actually going to be an hour delay before they can change their Apple ID password or these key settings on your iPhone. In iOS 17.3, you can access these settings by going to the Settings app, then scroll down to Face ID and Passcode, and then if we scroll down, you'll see Stolen Device Protection is turned on. I enabled it on the first update. And if you try to turn off the device protection, you'll see it's actually going to require Face ID. And to turn it off, there's going to be an hour delay before you can make any changes. And you'll see when I try to turn that off, even if it doesn't get a Face ID, it's not going to ask for your device passcode. It has to be able to scan your face before any changes can be made. It's not going to default to the device passcode. Now, if I let it scan my face, I can start the delay, and now you'll see an hour countdown timer before I can make any of those changes. And you'll see it'll actually show the time remaining before these changes can be made right here. Again, this is a huge step for iPhone security and that one weak point where if someone had your iPhone passcode and your physical iPhone, they could reset your Apple ID and everything. Now, even if they have those things, you'll have an hour to actually log in to Apple ID, apple.com, and change your device passcode, remove this iPhone or whatever Apple device from your account, and thieves won't be able to change those key pieces of information like your iCloud or Apple ID password and wreak havoc. Let me know which is your favorite new feature down in the comments, and if you're using that Journal app, hit that like button and subscribe to the channel. Lots of content coming. If you want to check out my in-depth review of the new Journal app, you can check out that video right up here. And if you want to learn about even more iOS 17 features, I have 17 hidden or just really hard to find features for iOS 17 in this video right here. Thanks for tuning in. I'll catch you next time.